our focus today is on making sure we're supporting them as researchers and scientists. But our focus in this budget is also on supporting them as they make their path through this challenging economy, understanding that the deck seems stacked against you right now in terms of how much you're paying on rent, how far off the dream of maybe owning a home one day might be. These are the things that we're focused on changing in this budget. We need to be investing in fairness, but part of investing in fairness and investing in that better future is making sure we're supporting the growth and the innovation that's going to lead to that. And that's why I'm so glad to be here at the University of Victoria. I want to thank Dr. Hall and Dr. Thomas for welcoming us here. This is a place that is consistently ranked in the top tier of Canada's research-intensive universities. I'm really happy to be here to talk about what we're doing to support our researchers and our scientists and grow our economy in ways that works for these young researchers and scientists behind me. This is what we did this week when we released our budget. We shared our plan to create fairness for every generation, especially millennials and Gen Z. Over the past few weeks, we've already talked about measures to build more homes faster and make measures to make life more affordable. We've also talked about our investments in technology and AI that will create good-paying jobs for Canadians and growth for our economy. Mais un des piliers importants de notre plan pour bâtir une économie plus équitable pour chaque génération, c'est de créer des bons emplois payants. Et pour ça, il faut s'assurer que le Canada puisse innover. We need to support problem solvers, innovators, and researchers. That's why Budget 2024 proposes historic measures that will strengthen Canadian research and innovation with investments of over $4.6 billion. Nos investissements. Nos investissements vont inclure 2,6 milliards de dollars pour bonifier les bourses pour la recherche fondamentale et pour soutenir la prochaine génération de talents en matière de recherche, des talents que j'ai derrière moi aujourd'hui. Ces investissements vont conduire à des découvertes sans précédent qui vont favoriser la croissance économique, que ce soit dans le secteur de la santé, de l'énergie propre ou d'autres secteurs essentiels. We will foster the next generation of research talent by increasing the annual value of master's and doctoral student scholarships and postdoctoral fellowships, and by increasing the number of students and fellows benefiting from these scholarships. We need to attract, develop, and retain Canada's top research talent, and this is exactly what these measures will do. We'll also help the younger generations get a good, affordable education with an investment of $1.3 billion, which means that for an additional year, we'll be maintaining the increase we brought to Canada Student Grants. We're also increasing the housing allowances used by the Canada Student Financial Assistance Program when determining financial need to provide additional student aid to approximately 79,000 students each year, which is particularly pertinent in areas where we know housing is particularly expensive, like Victoria. Now, we have some of the best scientists in the world here in Canada, and we're committed to getting them the best tools they need. Which is why, as part of this research and innovation package, we'll grow our world-leading research infrastructure by investing $734 million more. For example, we'll be investing to upgrade the Triumph Lab here in BC. Launched by UBC, SFU, and UVic, Triumph has been doing incredible work in physics research for over 50 years. En soutenant des laboratoires comme Triumph, on va aider des chercheurs canadiens à faire de nouvelles découvertes dans le domaine de la médecine, par exemple, pour trouver de nouveaux traitements contre le cancer ou des nouveaux médicaments. Et Triumph, c'est seulement un des exemples. Dans le budget, on soutient d'autres laboratoires et centres de recherche qui vont participer à des percées scientifiques qui vont aider à faire croître notre économie, comme le cyclotron à Saskatoon et le Snow Lab à Sudbury.